So we continue in part two, right? Parashat Ekev. V'alderech zeh mitbaer ha-pasuk. So according to what we just learned, the pasuk is going to be explained. Im bechukotai telechu, v'mitzvotai tishmeru, v'asitem otam. Right? So if you walk in my path, in my rules, and you keep them, right, or watch them, and you will do them. That it didn't say rak v'asitem otam, ala tishmeru v'asitem otam. That you should watch them, right, without any pniyot. This is what we learned. We know no interior motive. Right? So if we do that, then Hashem will reward us. וזהו פירוש הלשון, this is the explanation, שמירה, right? We said watching, guarding, keeping them. That it was mentioning few times in the Torah, and it was close to the commandment, to the tzivui, of actually fulfilling and doing the mitzvot, to teach us that the שמירה, watching them, it's like, it's an unseparate part from the mitzvah itself. Because doing the mitzvah in action, it's not perfect, right? It's not called shlemut ha-mitzvah, but only by watching it. So what is it watching? Not, doesn't mean to hire a security guard while you're doing the mitzvah to keep you safe. It is that you watch yourself. You look, you observe that I do the mitzvah because somebody is looking at me, but I do the mitzvah because I want to gain something from it. Maybe a kavod, maybe my name will be there. People will talk about me, whatever. No. You need to watch yourself that you're doing it only completely to Hashem. Hashem commanded us, and that's why we're doing it. Not for other any reason. Just for Hashem. Because he asked us to do it. Right? This is the Shmira. And then it will be perfect. And then we're going to get a reward. So before any mitzvah that we do, except I think giving tzedakah, there is a nusach that we said in any mechaven, right, that I'm aiming, or I have a kavana, or leshem yichud, kudsha, brichu, right, that we are uniting. It's like for example, when we're putting the tefillin, right, to fulfill the mitzvah of bor'i, right, we do leshem yichud, like we're uniting ourselves with Hashem, and we're preparing ourselves to do a mitzvah. And when we're doing that, right, we're actually preparing ourselves that we are going to do the mitzvah only because Hashem asks us. And then, by doing that, we will gain and we'll have the merit to have all the blessing that the Torah has mentioned. We can say strongly, as the Maran Bal Divrei Shmuel Zichrato Yagen Alein, he says, the Kasher Yehudi Ale La'olam Ha'Elyon, right, in 120, when we go up there, and we ask for a reward for what we worked, we put the effort, right, woke up very early in the morning, driving half an hour, going to the shul, it's not convenient, it's raining, it's hot, right? People are speaking, people are doing, right? It's an effort. We put an effort, it yagea, we sweat. So a guy go to Shamayim in 120 and he asked for the reward for the effort that he put. Now, if his work was, again, involved with pniyot, with interior motive and biased, etc., they will ask him, they will tell him actually, whoever you did it for, and you davened because you want him to look at you or whatever, you need to ask rewards from him. It is if like you worshiped him, right? So people think that idol worshiping, right, Avodah Zarah, it's only to bow to statues. But if somebody is doing it because he wants the Rav to look at him and see how righteous he is, then Hashem is telling him, ask the Rav because you worship the Rav, not me. And Maran Admor Bal Beit Avraham, Zichoto Hagenu Amar, right? Afilu Shepo, Sheyesh LaYehudi, Mashu Shel Torah Avodah, Im Zeh Be'emet Tikon La'ad, Lumat Zot, Kasher Yesh LaYehudi Chavilot Chavilot Shel Torah Avodah, Aval Chaser Be'emet Shelahem, Af Shevadai, En LaKadosh Baruch Hu Peach Sachar Ko Briya, Aval En LaKadosh Baruch Hu Sel, if a Jew have something in Torah and Avodah, he did something, but that something that he did is really truly, then that will stay with him for infinite. And in the other side, when a Jew have packages, bundles of Torah and Avodah, but something is missing in the honesty, then for sure he will get some kind of a reward for that. He will get a reward because after all, he did something, but it's not going to be a perfection in his Torah and the completion of the mitzvah. So now we just learned about the mitzvot and that we're doing it. Now he's jumping into the tshuva, right? After all, these parashiyot are in the Chodesh of Av, and we know that av, the sign of it is the tshuva, something very very nice that that I learned, that it's coming, I think, from the Arizal. There is a Gemara, right, that the person should not walk. It says, how you say that? Adif la'adam lalechet achre ari velo achre isha. That it's better for a person to walk behind a lion and not behind a woman. And everybody is looking at it like it's a chauvinistic thing or whatever. But what the Ria Kadosh is actually explaining, he says, it's better to walk behind a lion. Lion is Chodesh Av, Aryeh. That's the sign, the horoscope sign is Aryeh. It's better to do tshuva in the month of Av and not to wait to the months, which is sign is a betula, is Tishrei. Elul, sorry, Elul. Elul.
Virgo, Virgo.
What?
Virgo.
Virgo, yeah, Virgo, exactly. So it's better to walk behind the lion, which is to do a tshuva in the months of Av, and not to wait for the months of Elul, which will do the tshuva. So the months of Av, the main thing of it is the tshuva, right? That's why we are mourning the destruction of Bet HaMikdash, because not about what happened 2,000 years ago, it's because now it's not being built. It is like we have the contribution of the destruction. So we're mourning. So we need to do tshuva because we need to fix our ways. So whatever we learn now about the mitzvot, now he's bringing it to the tshuva. Moshe amar od maran, right? Tzchato agenu la pasuk, irchetsu maim. So they will wash with water. And water is a hint for a tshuva, because also the tshuva, we need to wash. Which means that our tshuva should be a good tshuva, right? Because sometimes the person do a tshuva, and the tshuva itself, with some kind of a pniot atzniot, even spiritually level, he have some kind of a motive to do the tshuva, but it's not really interesting in the tshuva itself, but on something else. And again, it's not going to Hashem. Ubezeish lefaresh, and we can explain the verse, v'avta et Hashem elokecha v'shamarta mishmarto, that we watch his watch, and the rules, and the rules, and the restriction, and everything. And shamarta, again, that the mitzvot should be pure with no interior motive. And then he doubled it, and he said, v'shamarta mishmarto, that goes on the tshuva. It's a hint for the tshuva. So also the tshuva needs to be clean and pure and with no other interior motive. The same way that you're going to wash it with the water. And also it says in our parsha later on, im shamor tishmerun, if you watch right double, it's a hint again that the tshuva itself needs to be kept and watched again. So a person should do a cheshbon nefesh, self-assessment. And this is what we are explaining in the Lashon. It says, "Anu vakshim batfilal," like we're really asking for tshuva. Shivenu avinu letoratecha, right? Bring us back to your Torah and get us closer to your avoda and return us in a tshuva shlema lefanecha, right? We're asking that the tshuva should be shlema, complete, with no other reasons and no other interior motive, etc. Right? So he says sometimes a Jew is really working hard and mityagea and is sweating in the Torah avoda, but he doesn't get into that perfection. But that's why we're asking Sfat Emet, that it should be truly Avoda and truly Torah and truly Tshuva. And according to that, it will explain what it says in the Pasuk, right? The special blessing that we have, Ve'evcha, that Hashem will love us, that we didn't find in other places. What does it mean? Like, we're keeping the Torah and the Mitzvot and Hashem will love us. V'ulefisha Madriga, because it depends on the level. Ha'madriga hazot lekeh mitzvah ka'ol, because if we are keeping the mitzvot in the level of that we're doing it only to Hashem, slowly, solely to Hashem, then actually a Jew can achieve that type of keeping mitzvot only when he have a pure love to Hashem and loving the mitzvah. It's a great level. Sometimes we're doing it because whatever reason and not because of we really love Hashem and we want to do it. Peer pressure, the wife, whatever. The friends are looking at us, right? She said that, but if we're really keeping the mitzvah from loving Hashem, then the pleasure that we get and the gain and the merit, that will be the real reward. And he's doing the mitzvah from Ahavat Hashem, v'lo shum pniyot. And because loving Hashem is a very divine, elevated, inspiring love that is like true love, then Hashem himself will bless us, be'vacha, that Hashem will love us, midah keneged midah. And this is the explanation from our sages, our Chazal, when they says vaya ekev tishmeun, right? And Rashi mefarish, these are the small easy mitzvot that the person doesn't even pay attention. He's dash be'akevav, like he's stepping on them, doing it, doesn't care about much. Because in the severe mitzvot, yeah, we're looking at the big one, right? Because we think that maybe the big one that we keep will have a better reward or a higher reward. But the small one, the easy one, the one that we don't even pay attention, they are light. It's a mitzvah light. We shouldn't really pay attention to that. But he says, no, it's not. You don't know the reward. And he says, this the big one, we're keeping the reward to our heart, to the attention, right? And the Godel HaMitzvah, that it's a big mitzvah. And still, it's also a pniot. And that's a problem, because the big one, very difficult not to think about, oh, I'm doing something big, something great. For sure, I'm going to get something from it. It's very difficult to not to think about it. But the small, easy, light one, we're doing it because we do it, right? We don't do it because of the reward, because it's a light mitzvah. Probably we're not going to get anything. Or, there's not a big punishment for that. So these mitzvot, we have a higher chance really to do from loving Hashem and really to do it without any motive, just to do the mitzvah, because we love that mitzvah. And then we love Hashem, and because of that, Hashem will love us. And then we actually will gain. So we have a really better chance to do the mitzvot that considered to be light, although nobody knows really what is light and what is not. Something that can look very big and difficult, maybe the reward is the same as like an easy light mitzvah just to do netilat yadayim. Who knows? We don't know. So we need to treat all the mitzvot the same way. Bezrat Hashem. Thank you very much for listening. And we Bezrat Hashem, we learn next week. What?